How's it hanging, fellas? I'm Orosh, and this is another episode of Cyberpunk 2077. And in today's episode, we're driving this silly little truck around. And you might wonder, why the fuck are we driving this silly little fucking truck around? Eh, no reason. I just picked it up, thought it was pretty funny looking. What am I delivering? I don't know. But you know what I've been doing yesterday? I watched, A Big Trouble in Little China. And man, is that movie fucking fun to watch. It's so fucking... That movie does not bore you at any moment. Maybe it's because of its runtime that it's only 1.5 hours. And that's a perfect fucking length of a movie for me. Because it's not too much, not too little. Maybe 2 hours is slightly better, but whatever. Whoa, shit. And yeah, I just really fucking like that movie. This movie just constantly, the dialogue in it, it's like, whenever one person finishes saying something, and immediately another one just starts fucking yelling over them, almost. It's like this movie doesn't fuck around. It's like they had a 2-hour movie or something, and then they figured that, oh shit, we gotta fit it in like, we gotta fit it in like 1.5 hours. So they just like shoved everything together. If it's a cyber psycho problem, there was very little of scenes, like establishing scenes or something, where they're like, oh man, look at this building for 2 minutes now. It looks sinister, doesn't it? Now they just fucking saw the building, walked in, fucked people up. At the beginning, the movie begins with like, what's his name? Jack. Something with a B. What's up, Johnny? Beautiful view. Remember how we went to a roller coaster one time? It was really great. Pacifica. This building looks pretty scary. I wonder if like people, like I don't know, like voodoo boys maybe took over the whole abandoned construction site. Who the fuck's breathing so heavily? Jesus Christ, Johnny. And what the fuck are those things in the background? Is that like a dam? Is this like a thing that separates this city from the rest of the world? Excuse me, ma'am, can you shut the fuck up? Ah, she left. You're ruining my time viewing the beautiful view of the ocean, bitch. That missile certainly deals a lot of damage. I like that missile. At first I thought it would be like a separate weapon, like the fists and the blades and the wire I hit before, right? The wire was the shittiest. The wire was like nothing interesting. What the fuck's wrong with her feet? Who's into that shit? It looks like a fucking lobster. Gross. Disgusting. She basically has no feet. She has like 2 pointy fucking sticks for feet. A lot of shotgun ammo. I gotta reach shards now. Are those the ones? I don't know which ones it's supposed to be. Yeah, so at first, Jack. Not Baker. Jack drives around the truck, right? And he seems like, it seems like he, you know, like at the beginning it's just like, oh, he's like a cool trucker guy, he drives a truck, he has like a mullet, he looks pretty cool as fuck. And then he meets up with these Chinese people, he gambles with them, and then he ends up having to do a favor to one of them, where he has to go and help one of them pick up his girlfriend from China at the airport. But at the airport, a bunch of Chinese gangsters, which I think were called... They had like a really dumb name, I forgot what it was though. I better fucking read all of those in case they fucking want you to. Why did she murdered all of the recording crew, it seems like. They caught her bad side or something? The cables leading to this equipment here. A corpse, a light. Some more lights. This guy seemed like he was kinda here security or something. And then they seem to have thrown out some people down there. I remember I had a lot of trouble with this quest. You know why? Because I didn't read those shards. I don't know why, but I think something also broke where the quest didn't told me to read, it just told me to look for stuff. So I was looking for stuff. But it turns out I had to read shards that I found. Unless I actually didn't find one of them, and that's why I couldn't progress. Get a load of this. Yeah, it seems like we're getting closer to finishing all those cyber psychos out. It's good. It's a good thing. Yes, I'm glad how this missile works. It's fucking awesome. Wait, what? I don't know why I thought it said Saints Row. Where's my cute little truck? There it is. Driving it around. I'm a trucker now. Just like Jack. Damn it, he said his name so many times in that movie. And yeah, I can't remember now, fuck. But anyway, and the girl gets kidnapped. And then just fucking insanity happens. They chase after the gangsters, and then like Raiden shows up from Mortal Kombat, starts shooting lightning out of his hands, and there's like three of them.
V, a few Zeta Tech corporals walked into an auto shop. The punchline, none came back out.
Apparently, oh, really funny. Why the fuck she called me like that? I didn't even answer. She just fucking invited herself in. Fucking bitch.
And you know I got a nose for this stuff.
There's another cyber psycho around here. Is that him? I can't see the cyber psycho. Gotta disarm these damn missiles or I'm gonna blow up. And then it turns out that so much shit that happens in that movie, but basically what turned out is that there's this demon lord, ancient like Chinese emperor, who's is stuck in his like really old body. About every scene involving that emperor was pretty funny. A lot of really funny shit in that movie. It's mostly an action movie. A really cool one too. But there's a lot of like really silly stuff. Jack himself is pretty silly. He doesn't act too serious. Like he seems to be more annoyed by everything. You know that he got himself involved in this. He's constantly saying how he just wants to get his truck back. But you know his motivation is more than just getting a truck back. A good guy, you know. At first I thought it would be like Jack would turn out to be like a fighter, because at the beginning they show how his reflex, he has like really good reflexes catching bottles out of the air, right? Before they hit him. So I figured, oh, he's probably gonna kick ass. He doesn't really kick ass in the movie. It's mostly everybody else who kicks ass in the movie. And literally one time he knocked himself out by like shooting a ceiling, and then the ceiling just like collapsed onto his head and he knocked himself out. But he did kill the emperor at the end, and I just want to point that out. He did this in the most fucking funny way imaginable. He had a knife with him the whole movie, like he had it attached to his like leg, and he was gonna fight, so he threw the knife at the emperor trying to like kill him, and the emperor just caught the knife and he was like, that's a nice knife. Oh jeez, I almost blew myself up. right? And everybody gives him that look where it's like, oh, what the fuck did you do? And then his reflexes finally come into the plot, I guess, where the Emperor throws the knife back at him, and he catches it and throws him back at him, and hits him in the head. Like, the ancient fucking Emperor with a demon soul, killed in this dumb of a way, I just find really funny. I gotta search something, but what? Oh, the computer. Who the fuck leaves a computer outside like that? In the rain. You think this computer... These computers... This game is full of those computers. You didn't never see a different one. You think it's some kind of brand of computer that's so fucking versatile? It's good for everything. It's good for gaming. Good for, like, doing your work at home. Just everything in general. For fuck's sake, it's so easy to get around me. For Christ's sake. Like I pointed out before, LEGO City Undercover has a better fucking NPC AI than this game. I'm not even making a joke, that's true. I had to reply. Watson Horror, I don't really understand what Watson Horror is about. Not that I'm too curious to find out. Maybe a little bit, but not too much. This is a vehicle. That's good. This one seems to be more in this area. We could do this one more and then, like, next episode, I guess we could start doing some kind of side quest. That's actually more important than just fucking going around doing dumbass side missions. Yeah, and, I really liked it. I don't know what I can say. You know, if I watched it before I started this video, I probably had a lot to say about it, but now I just kind of can't remember some stuff. I liked how during one scene where they were kidnapped in like a Chinese restaurant,
he fucked up. Gotta pick him up.
They have guns, and there's a funny scene where they keep like exchanging guns between each other. Like they can't make up who the fuck should have which gun. And Jack ends up with a fucking Tech 9. And he kinda has it for the rest of the movie, which I thought was pretty interesting.
So I gotta do it now?
No, no, I don't need you.
Damn it, I don't need this highlighted, fuck off.
Good.
So annoying, there's so much shit on top of each other in this game. For example, zooming in on enemies. Look, when you aim at an enemy, and then you press up, you go through the option of what to do to them. So if you wanna fucking take a closer look at an enemy, you gotta look away from an enemy, then zoom in, and now I can take a closer look at him. Look, he has a haircut and a collar. Awesome. Fuck. Everything I ever wanted him to have. Who are these people, by the way? Is this like another gang that I already ran into, or are these some enemies I haven't met before? Ah, get it! Come on! I think they're Valentinos. I think this place is pretty much full of Valentinos. Turn the camera off. You guys have some more movies that you maybe recommend. I was gonna watch more Godzilla movies, but I also figured that I might watch some more, like... I just wanna, like, finish all the shorter movies I have on my watch list, cause, I don't know, every time I sit down to watch, like, a long movie, usually what happens, I ran out of popcorn, like, I don't know, 30 minutes for the movie. Then, what happened? Ooh, legendary. Nice. Got a legendary vest. You know what I want to do in this game? Maybe I'll do it next time, like when they finally fucking fix this game. I would like to come back to this game and do a playthrough. Call me a sick fuck, but I would like to do a playthrough where I would play as a fucking naked dude just going around everywhere. Like, I would maybe go with hacking so I wouldn't even, like, fight people. Or maybe that's a better idea, maybe... No. Unless they actually manage to fix fist fights. But I don't think they'll fix fist fights, because fist fights aren't broken in this game. They just suck. I thought that was a nice car I could have steal. I don't know why, but when I was doing blue quests, I found this like really nice fucking car. And I found it in like a garage. And I figured that this must be a car I can keep. Because I never seen a car like that on the streets. And I figured like, oh, it must be important, right? Was this that it? I'm such a stealthy master. Oh, I killed his girlfriend. Oh. Who will he spend Oh my god. I just remembered. Valentine's Day. Fuck. Okay, I think I meant to do a Valentine's special, right? Oops, I kind of forgot. They even noticed me? I don't think they noticed. Oh, I gotta drive all the way somewhere. Delivered stupid Militec truck. I wouldn't call this an SUV. Would you call this an SUV? I don't know what an SUV is, but I always imagine it's more like a... I don't know, this is more like a truck looking thing, like a Jeep. Ah, then again, I don't know what the fuck an SUV is. So maybe this is an SUV. Maybe Jeeps and trucks are SUVs. Is it the same guy again? No. And drive through it? Whoa. Future. It's pretty futuristic.
Yo, it's me.
Jesus Christ, what? Who?
When I was with the family, we settled this stuff on our own turf.
Don't think we know that? They didn't give us a way out. First, we came in to see the goods. Exchange was supposed to happen the next day.
But
they followed us to where we hid our money. It's whatever, though. I'm done dwelling. Thanks for the help. I'm out of here.
Sure. Later.
Spread the word that even though I haven't been in the camp recently, I'm still helping you out. Surprised Panem isn't getting mad about that. Oh, sorry.
Sublime work, V. I know I can count on you. The nomads are grateful for your help.
Sublime work.
Contract closed.
Day. You know what I just realized? Huh, never mind, I guess. Meet Hanako and Embers. Watch more fun movies. I wonder if I'll manage to get, like... Maybe I'll go with cool. If I... Fuck intelligence. I don't want to play as an intelligent character. Here we go. This is must have for me. Should have invested in this at the beginning of the game. Now I would have easy access to like a bunch of easily fucking craftable legendary stuff. So next episode, I think we're going to... Oh, there was a quest here still. Shit. Whatever. There's a quest here, this is a car, there's no more quests here. There's the Fool on the Hill quest line, but I still need one more of those pictures. That's this thing I meant to do. Oh, but I might do it now. Just so these will be the two areas I'll have left. Alright, where's my car? Oh no, I left my cute little truck in the fucking place I've been to. Shit. Why is this fucking car keep spawning inside different cars? Never mind, I thought I did that again. One another thing I wanna, like, kinda get into, right? Since I've been watching, like, Star Trek recently and all those older movies. I feel like, oh, maybe I should, like, find somewhere. Stuff like Miami Vice and watch that shit. Because I never watched it as a kid. Only... show I watched like that was Heat Acapulco. Acapulco Heat, whatever it was called. And Magnum PI, the older one with the guy with a mustache. Magnum. but those ones, it's like, as a kid I didn't pay attention to whenever I watched stuff on TV. I often like put stuff on TV and then I would like do different things as the TV was on. So I didn't like pay full attention to stuff. Entered the electronics store. I'm gonna buy myself a video game. Actually, what was the next video game I was gonna buy? I was either gonna buy... Nah, I was gonna buy SpongeBob.
Balance keeps Rogue. That city alive. Without it,
haven't
all
seen
beat each other's throats.
Heard from her in a while.
Corps, gangs, marks, everyone. And where do fixers fit in? If one side starts to get too much power, a fixer can help tip the scales toward the other, discreetly. Think about it. Balance keeps biz from running dry. Anyway, why the lecture, right? Because it's time for a little intervention. Check the attachment.
Alright. Do I just walk in, or do you mean I walk in and kill people? Or do you mean I sneak in? La la la. Hold the fuck up, I gotta highlight enemies. Not the fucking vending machine, enemies. Unless the vending machine is my enemy.
Half this trash is older than me. Gong's actually come
here. Excuse me.
Shut your trap.
I'm here to buy a Nintendo Switch.
What? Want something?
Yes.
Never stands in no fucking line.
Some hefty price tags here.
Price of quality, Chubata.
Quality? This place looks like garbage.
Been in biz here long.
Huh?
A lot of years of sales under your belt, it seems.
It's trash on the floor. You guys clean this fucking place anytime?
Get the fuck out.
Well, give me my shit, dude.
Mr. Manager, the valued customer wants to know what we sell.
What? Oh, wire.
Some garbage.
Other electronic shit.
You heard the manager.
Heard you sling some pretty serious tech around here.
Listen, you're gonna shop or you ain't. Here's what we got.
What should I buy? A guitar pick, a flare, a hand fan. I don't have a Nintendo Switch. Vinyl records. None of the bands I actually like. Fuck. A rosary. That's a... electronic rosary, of course. Upgrades. Oh, I have a legendary pistol. Excuse me, when the fuck did I find a legendary pistol? This is actually really interesting. Nice. You already don't have the money to fucking... really? And you suck. Alright. I'm out of here. I literally sold them guns. They could use to fucking kill me with it. Oh, whoops. Actually, I think I... Come here, big guy. For being so big and having such a thick neck, you kinda get it snapped really easily. You think it would be harder than just like... what, pulling them back and like moving their neck up? That's it? That all it takes to fucking break someone's neck? Fuck. Is there another window I can sneak through? Seems like there is one in the back. Jesus Christ, stop lagging like that. You know, this might go really badly, but I need to see if this gun even works. Well, it kinda does. Damn it, well, this isn't a stealth game, this is all focused on gun stats. But what I try to do right now... Oh, now it worked. See, this is what I'm trying to achieve, a gun that can, like, stealthy kill people for me. Damn it, you fucking asshole. I was trying to make myself a stealth gun. And yeah, I guess it works. Don't look in the mirror, this is like the worst moment to look in the fucking mirror now. Try to pick up this thing. There seems to be still enemies around. It's for not selling me my Switch, bitch. The enemy that I have highlighted seems to be like far away. Oh, maybe there's people underground. Didn't thought there would be enemies underground. So I changed my scope on this gun. Last time I had it, I had a different scope. So I figured, you know, this would probably be better to aim with a scope like that. This guy seems big and scary. This gun isn't the worst. It's pretty cool. Pretty cool gun. I don't even know where did I get the new legendary gun. Seems to be even cooler though. Also, you know what? The game doesn't really show you enemy stats. So it kind of makes me curious. Oh. So maybe I wasn't supposed to kill her? She dead or not? Well, check it out, I got a dead body with me. Want it? Want a dead body? No? Alright. Maybe you. Whatever, I'll put it in this glitched out car. I think I fucked it up.
Package received. Thank you, V. Keep up the good work. The streets will remember your name.
They already do. I'm like 50 level street cred. The cars get stuck in the ground. Great. I remember this one quest that I completely ruined. I like got spotted while I was trying to do stealthy. And I was like, man, I fucked it up. And then I got a phone call, expected to get scolded for fucking up. And then I got praised for doing so good. There's two quests here, this one isn't even a quest. We're gonna do this next time. We're finally gonna meet with this lady. And we're gonna do her quest line next time. So see you fellas in the next episode. Bye.